course, the taller woman by 3 inches. She did miss weight by 2 pounds. She forfeits 20% of her purse. Morris will have a 5-inch reach advantage. All right, now for the introductions. Here's Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC bantamweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a mixed martial artist holding professional record, 5 wins, 6 losses. She stands 5 feet 7 inches tall, weighing in at 138 pounds. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, USA, by way of Kelowna, British Columbia, Canada, Sarah Cheesecake Morris. And now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a mixed martial artist holding professional record, 7 wins, 2 losses. She stands 5 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 134 pounds. Fighting out of Tbilisi, Georgia, USA, Liana She-Wolf Jojua. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Mark Goddard.
Kind of like how Buffer punched that Jojua. Mark Goddard, our referee, the lovely Luciana Andrade, getting us started for round one. In this bantamweight tilt between Sarah Morris and Liana Jojua. Jojua, the minus 170 betting favorite tonight. This fight clock is brought to you by Modelo. Morris in the white top with black trunks. Jojua with the red shorts. Jojua felt like she would have a decided striking advantage here tonight, but certainly didn't think she was at a grappling or wrestling disadvantage against the grappling Morris. Toyo Tires, the official tire of the UFC. And longtime sponsor of the great Dominic Cruz.
Oh man, Toyo Tires,
the best.
Jojua definitely believes that the striking advantage is with her, but right now the jab of Morris is causing, you know, the most offense, really. She's just throwing the jab, looking for big punches, and she's landed definitely a lot more. Jojua looks to just kind of be freezing. Just, she needs to be first, because right now she's getting tagged up with that jab.
Nice left hook from Sarah Morris.
Right now, Morris just looks more comfortable, to be honest. Nice right hand lands. You know, and this is her being here before. She was on the Ultimate Fighter. Anybody who's been on the Ultimate Fighter, especially, you know, Team Misha Tate in those matchups, I mean, they got a lot of experience if you go through those shows. So Morris definitely has a little bit more in the range of fight experience in the UFC.
And Jojua did expect some nerves here in this UFC debut. Joe Silva would call them jitters, but she feels like she's nervous for every fight and feels like some of those nerves are good nerves. She was certainly all business during fight week. She's been in Abu Dhabi 2 weeks, came out way early. She's got a pretty good Russian following and some support here in the arena tonight.
Morris with the underhooks, looking for the early takedown as expected. See if she can get it. Head position is key. That's where she's putting her head is turning. Jojua flat on her back. See how she's just square. That'll allow a takedown. Trips her there. Drop into the double leg is there. Right now, Morris just happy with the dirty boxing here, though.
Talk about 7 now UFC fights for Sarah Morris. 3 more on the Ultimate Fighter. Twice she has faced Juliana Pena, one of the meanest women in MMA. So a lot of high-level experience for Sarah Morris coming in tonight.
Yeah, and that's what you're seeing here, really, I think, is she just doesn't look very nervous, and I kind of, Jojua kind of looks like frozen in the headlight type of look. She's sitting there waiting for Morris to be first. Morris just pushing the action. She's got takedowns here. Let's see if she can get it, though, because staying on the upper body is really just keeping Jojua stuck.
Morris staying heavy here in the clinch. Under 2 minutes here to go in the round. When Jojua won the Fight Night Global Bantamweight Championship, it was the first time Russia had crowned a women's bantamweight champion. That was all the way back in early 2018. We asked her about competing in the first women's fight for the UFC in Abu Dhabi, and she deadpanned, "I'm used to making history." So we'll see if Jojua now can get what is the chief priority, and that's a W. Mark Goddard watching the action closely, allowing the fighters to work in the clinch.
Wait for Morris to drop down to that double leg. It's definitely there, but so far she's happy with just staying on the clinch and doing damage here, it looks like. Already 39 strikes to 13 by Morris, getting ahead on the scorecards.
So the referee not seeing enough action. He separates the fighters. Mora presses forward. Looked like Joe Jua landed there.
Mora's just landing first, being just aggressive.
Some wild activity here on the feet. Looked like maybe a clash of heads in there. Seems to be a strength advantage for Sarah Morris.
Joe is pretty much waiting on Morris to be first, and that's going to be a problem if the fight keeps going this way for her.
All right, good start for the underdog Morris. Back with round two after this.
Start!
Come here.
Sit down.
How's your arms?
Just relax right now. Don't panic. Work very carefully. Don't wait for her. That's your problem. So get it. Don't wait for her. You attack. Move and attack.
Deep breath.
Get those jabs sharper. Feint jab, jab. Double step, jab, jab, right. Step back.
I believe that left hand is there too. Okay.
She keeps countering.
Stream over 20 live combat sports events from around the world this month, including the best in MMA, kickboxing, boxing, Muay Thai, and more. Plus, Canadian boxing sensation Cody Crowley makes his UFC Fight Pass debut this October. Every week is Fight Week on UFC Fight Pass. So a lot of the message in the Joe Jua corner, Dominic, from Murad Bichuev, her chief coach, was what you said.
Well, you just got to be first. You can't sit. Joe Jua really does look frozen in the headlights, like something's coming at her and she's just freezing. You've got to be first in these matchups, especially against Morris, who's looking for the clinch and the takedowns. You've got to push her back and you got to be piecing together combinations. I would even say Joe Jua could go to the body a little bit if she's nervous going to the head, but right now just staring and waiting isn't working.
Pretty significant mouse under the right eye of Sarah Morris.
Body head on that one, and she landed the left hook, and that's probably the best punch she's landed the whole fight, is that left hook.
Oh, nice knee from Sarah Morris as she gains the clinch yet again. Minute gone by here, round two.
Morris will always have the most success in this clinch in her matchups because she likes to keep it dirty and then get that takedown and really look for the submission. So if she can get a takedown, it'll be a big advantage for Morris.
Dennis Davis among those in that Extreme Couture corner of Sarah Morris. A lot of fighters say every fight in the UFC is a must-win, but certainly some pressure on Sarah Morris coming in here tonight, only compounded by the fact that she didn't hit that 136-pound number here yesterday.
Okay, you got to make weight. Everybody knows that. It's part of the job. It's like going to work and showing up late, basically. You can't do that. Sometimes you get fired. But right now, it's all Morris, and she's just powerhousing Joe Jua up against the fence, keeping the head position, doing the right stuff, keeping constantly going for the trips the way she's doing, hooking the legs, attacking the legs with the heels and stuff. It just throws off Joe Jua's mindset on pummeling and working the hands. Now she's got the back of her, and she's looking to take it.
For first round situation of the fight. Jojua gets a takedown. Morris staying active with the elbows. She's got that high guard. She's had success winning rounds fighting off her back in the UFC against Alexis Dufresne, I believe, back in the day. That high guard really keeps Jojua from being able to posture and land any punches, and allows her to set up the armbar. She wants to get the armbar here. Now she's like a triangle transition. Both arms are in there, but she's trying to switch to an armbar. Nice elbow. Watch out for that armbar, Morris. She's landed those before. She's good with them. And she's searching for it right now. She's going back and forth between looking for the triangle and the armbar. And now she's able to kick Jojo on her back. And this isn't good. As Morris really likes the grappling position, she's going to get more and more momentum. Big elbow lands over the top.
You can just see her confidence on the ground, whether it's off her back or inside the now closed guard of Liana Jojua. Striking advantage for Morris, 91-31. A lot of those in the clinch and not at distance, but strong start for nearly 9 minutes for Sarah Morris.
Morris doing a good job staying busy. If anything, you know, anything else, she's staying busy. She keeps attacking, and she's trying to better her position each time. So she's not just sitting there freezing.
Jojua controlling posture, trying to get a stand up from the referee. Now a couple elbows. Morris loads up, didn't appear to land those elbows. A couple short shots from Jojua off of her back. Now you see Morris putting her hand over the mouth of Jojua. That elbow found the target. But a good visual for the judges. If you are Sarah Morris, round three is yours next. Stop.
Don't worry, everything will be okay. You're still panicking. You gotta work. Third round, you gotta work. Don't wait for her again. Your mistake is you waiting for her. Breathe.
You get on top again, try to look for a quick pass in the half guard, right? And then give me some damage from there, right? Hey, 5 minutes, right? 5 minutes, let's go.
Back live in Abu Dhabi, round three is brought to you by P3, the official protein snack of the UFC. Good stuff from Dennis Davis there in the corner of Sarah Morris, keeping it simple. Wants her to pass into half guard and try to land some significant ground strikes, but certainly feels like his fighter is ahead as we come up on the final 5 minutes.
Well, the left hook Jojua landed, that's the biggest punch so far, but realistically it's Morris the whole time pretty much. She's just being first, landing the most strikes. A nice knee timing, but she gets taken down even though she looks for it. And that's at least Jojua going first on something. She's been waiting, staring in the mirror for a while, and really it just looks like she's a little inexperienced compared to Morris is what I'm seeing more than anything. That high guard is working for her. She's going to look to transition to an armbar from here. But Jojua doing the right thing, crowding. She's moving forward.
Morris with that high closed guard now. rarely is she looking to hip escape or get up off of her back. She just likes to throw offense.
Well, realistically, the high guard is what's keeping her there and safe. How she puts the legs right behind the neck and the shoulders of JoJua, that keeps JoJua from being able to posture and punch. You see, and then she comes down into the triangle. It just makes it annoying for JoJua to do any offense. So what will happen is the ref will stop him because JoJua can't sit up and do anything, and she can't pass. It's just a good job by Morris to nullify any of the offense from the top position of JoJua, and that's why JoJua just gets out.
Morris waited until JoJua was up off the ground to land that kick partially.
Stuffs the takedown, takes the back, and that's JoJua just freezing after the takedown. And right there, she transitions to the mount. It's just transition over transition. Morris is just ahead right now.
Oh, and now Morris loading up on the elbow. She has mounted JoJua. Certainly plenty of time here with which to work under 3 minutes to go in the fight. Pretty good scramble by JoJua, but she gives up her back.
Yeah, she's got good ground control here, and she's really putting it on JoJua right now. Got the mount position, raining elbows and punches, staying nonstop busy, not losing the position, pushing the face framing and then elbowing. I mean, it's just very nice. It's, it might get stopped here soon if she doesn't start defending herself.
And that'll do it. Sarah Morris by TKO.
Yeah, Morris really showed up for this one.
So with her back against the proverbial wall, Sarah Morris gets the finish tonight. She spoils the UFC debut of the newcoming Georgian Liana JoJua. Pretty complete effort from Sarah Morris. A little shine off of it because of the weight miss, but she really came in here tonight a woman with a purpose and got it done in a big way.
Yeah, what I saw in this matchup is JoJua just having not enough experience, realistically.